That's what the scripture says. 2 Corinthians 13:5. Examine yourselves as to whether or not you're in the faith. Test yourselves. Do you not know yourselves that Jesus Christ is in you? The most important thing you can do in response to this message is to make sure that you are truly a Christian. And you are not a Christian just because you grew up in the church. You are not a Christian just because your parents are Christians. You're not a Christian because you've lived a good life. You are not a Christian because you have served in the church and done great things for God. One of the most sobering passages in the Bible is found in Matthew chapter 7. Here's what it says. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many, said Jesus, will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name? Have we not cast out demons in your name? Have we not done many wonders in your name? And I will say to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness. Is there a more stark, frightening verse than that? Jesus is not saying that good works do not matter. What he is saying is that good works will not get you to heaven. If you want to read more about this, I suggest you read the book of James when you get home today. Go back to the 2 Corinthians passage. It says, do you not know that Christ is in you? Let me ask you that question. Do you know that Christ is in you? Have you put your trust in him? Are you certain that he's living in your heart? This is not some cultural Christianity. Sometimes people grow up in Christian families and they think, well, my parents were Christians. My brothers and sisters are Christians. I must be a Christian too. Not. God doesn't have any grandchildren. He just has children. So that's the most important thing. Has there ever been a time in your life when you have personally invited Christ to forgive you of your sin and become your Savior? That is what matters. That is what determines whether you are a true Christian or a Christian in name only. That's the one thing. If you get that straight, you will never fall away. Number two,